At the turn of the century, we lived in a very different world. The motor car had not been invented, there were no computers, no telephones, and man had not yet walked upon the moon. Life was simple, and work was hard. In a world filled with time-saving devices, we seem to have endless opportunity to spend more time doing the things that matter most in our lives. But somehow we haven't known when to stop. In our desperate attempt to make our lives easier, we work harder and longer than ever before. And with all our time and labor-saving devices, we seem to take fewer holidays and spend less time with all the people we love the most. The more time and labor-saving devices we invent to make our lives easier, the more money we need to save, and the harder we have to work to get them. The more we've improved our environment to make life easier, the more complicated we've made it. So now our children are sentenced to 15 to 20 years at school and universities just to learn how to survive in this complex and stressful environment we've made for ourselves. We're encouraged to fit so much activity into every day that each minute in our lives is controlled by the clock. And so our days are chopped up into little pieces, and each segment of time is allocated and controlled by a clock, a sign, or a set of rules. Although we live by the clock, we can't turn the clock back to a simpler time where our wealth was measured in smiles and laughter. It's no wonder that most of us are searching for something that relieves us from the stress and strain of modern-day living. Pills, cigarettes, comfort foods, alcohol and other drugs are often used to provide temporary relief from our stressful lives. But perhaps we could find a better way of dealing with stress. A way of dealing with stress that doesn't rely on drugs or comfort food.
I would like to invite you now to close your eyes. Thank you.